Okay, so there's this gaming chair company called EITY. They photoshopped a photo of me sitting in an @TLDtoday video and used it as an ad for years. Never seen their chair in my life, and I don't care if the chair is great, this is trashy. Don't buy their stupid chair. I seriously wonder how many times MKBHD has to deal with this. How many times people falsely say that he's reviewed something, or simply said a product was in good quality just so they could sell some stuff. I'm almost certain he and maybe some lawyers are busy combing through all sorts of stuff like that, because I'm sure there are tons of fake images like that all across the internet. Oh my god, Stanley was a bigot. Oh my god, I thought these arguments were done years ago. Let the man rest. He said Peter Parker could never be gay, so stop with Stan Lee worshiping. He's not only refused to make Spider-Man queer, he's also stated that Spider-Man should never be gay. If you continue to idolize him, then you're just as bad. Oh my god, okay, yeah, he said Peter Parker shouldn't be gay, because the character wasn't written with the intention to be queer. There is more to LGBTQ+ inclusion than just queer-washing already established non-queer characters. And also, Peter Parker isn't the only Spider-Man. Stan Lee created X-Men to show how we shouldn't discriminate or be afraid of people just because they're different. That's whom you're trying to paint as a bigot. It's really funny when you hear dumb arguments like this, because at the end of the day, if you really wanted more quote-unquote queer superheroes, why couldn't you just write your own comics? Why are you waiting for Marvel and DC and other comics producers to produce all the content that you want, with all the inclusion that you want, and then complaining that they're too slow? Why don't you just create the stories that you want to read? It's truly that simple, but hey, yeah, tearing something down is a lot easier than creating something. Ooh, so I put my son's PS4 controllers in the oven last night to hide them so he could go to bed. Didn't tell the wife who put the oven on this morning. How did she manage to do it last night when this image has been online for the last 2 days? Now, this one is a little strange. I think the guy who responded just didn't get the joke. I think it was supposed to be a funny. I don't think it's somebody trying to act like they did something quirky. If that's the case, then I'll totally take my statement back. But I have a feeling this was supposed to be just an internet joke that this guy took a little too seriously. Yo, how fragile are you? A photorealistic art has no purpose and requires no talent. Period. Deal with it. Can you explain how you think photorealistic art requires no talent? Could you reproduce an album just by listening to it? Could you cook a 5-course meal just by looking at the plates of food? Could you build an entire house yourself because you've seen a house before? I think my man's at the start was a little bit confused between modern art and photorealistic art, which is a shame because it really shouts how ignorant he is, and that ignorance led to a really awful comment about how photorealistic art has no purpose and requires no talent. And I seriously love it. I like it when people are so just confident in their ignorance that they leave themselves wide and open for people like this guy to rip them apart. Worst service since COVID-19 took effect. The lady who supposedly is the owner is very shrewd and doesn't care about any sort of customer service ethics, nor does she seem to care about the insights of having your food spiced. And get this, I told her that my wife was pregnant and I wanted Indian curry that wasn't spicy at all, and she misinterpreted us and made the food extra spicy after putting our phone order on conversation short. I understand that we were going through a pandemic, but that does not give you the right to act like you're a monopoly. You know you don't have to lie and make up stories, right? You ordered with us before, and we know how to cook our food. And your wife called, and she wanted it specifically hot. We reminded her that the food is hot, and it's going to be very spicy, but she insisted and said, I quote, "We're Indian, and we can handle it." She never mentioned she was pregnant, and once when you picked up the food, you still complained, and we refunded your entire money back, so I'm not sure what else we can do to please you, and please don't call us and make up stories to trash our reputation. Just because you can write unsubstantiated lies doesn't mean we will not respond back and take these allegations seriously. You are more than welcome to take your business someplace else that satisfies you. And lastly, don't use COVID as an excuse. Through this pandemic, we suffered the most and still managed to stay open and serve our community. The biggest thing, the strangest thing about this conversation between the customer and the owner is simply that it's the result of whether or not curry was too spicy or not enough. The world we live in is so free of actual problems, this is what actually causes arguments between people, and it is hilarious and gorgeous. The last thing Osama bin Laden saw was an American flag. It was on my shoulder, and I was standing. This by far is the best response today. Oh my god. He didn't even say anything. That's right. It was like midnight when the guy got killed. Like, oh my god. Why are you capping on Twitter? Oh, Oh yeah, that's why. 138,000 reasons why you would lie on Twitter. Makes sense to me. I will never go back to this place. They watched me walk in and get all the way up to the counter and then looked up laughing to tell me that they were closed by 3 minutes. They thought it was hilarious. I will drive back to another establishment before I go here, man. Bruh, you clearly came in after closing. Our employees did not laugh, but actually nicely told you that we were closed at 6. You proceeded to have an attitude and stormed out. Everything is recorded, and we're more than happy to share the footage of what happened with anyone who asks. If you're going to show up after hours and expect service then lie about what happens, then please go elsewhere. We don't want customers like you. Why is that always the case with these stories, man? It's always people who just misinterpret the rules or just straight up show up after closing. Imagine being so hungry and entitled that you're willing to shout at somebody for not selling you a sandwich after the store is closed. That's ridiculous. Hey guys, could you please help me out? I'm going to tag the Animal Control and Shelter on Facebook. I have a stolen basset hound, female Henrietta, stolen from this street. Dude, she wasn't stolen. You're a meth head, and your girl sold her. Yeah, that's far from stolen. Tell people the truth. You did not take care of her in any way, and Animal Control and the police both agreed. Far from stolen, you're just unfit for dogs, period. If all of that is true, then this ad is extremely strange. What does she have to gain from saying that the dog is stolen? Then there's nothing that he could do. The dog is no longer his, and he just made this ad for clout? For probably trying to get the dog back for free. I don't understand. Place was pretty dirty. My clothes would have caught on fire if I didn't notice smoke in the air and the awful smell. I had to throw out a whole load of my whites. When I asked the quote-unquote caretaker for the owner's phone number, he claimed that he only speaks to them when they call him. Therefore, he didn't know their number. I found that to be slightly unprofessional and just plain bad business. Please do not put plastic in the machines. We saw this on camera and there was no fire. Please go somewhere else. How do you accidentally put plastic in a dryer or a washing machine? I think it's a dryer because her clothes got ruined. So she had melted plastic on all of her clothes, and instead of actually, you know, owning up to her own mistake, she throws it on the owner and the caretaker, and the poor caretaker probably has to clean that dryer now. He has to scrape all that plastic out, and if he can't do it, the owner has to buy a new one. So yeah, it would be better for everybody for you to go to a new place, woman. Okay, so this image is really, really personal to me. It's about my personal emotional triumphs, and really, I just drew myself versus my depression. And I wanted to share it with you guys because, you know, I'm a teenager and this is Reddit and I heard that this is a great place to share art and stuff. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. Wow, that's nuts. I don't even know what to say other than the fact that you just legit copied a page from the manga Vagabond. Oh my god, it gets even better. It's simply one thing to say a study from Takehiko Inoue's works that I made and I'm proud of, but making a study of someone else's work and then trying to claim it as your own, or even making up some story about how it's you versus your depression, is simply just plagiarism. I didn't get my message. Hey, at somebody. You would have only got a message had you not received the initial Bitcoins for purchasing the game. I didn't receive the initial ones, though. Uh-huh, so according to this message you did, it's either I'm lying or you're just trying to gyp more in-game currency out of us, which we're not going to give you. I ordered some honey chicken, shrimp fried rice, and chicken wings tonight. I ordered previously with this spot, and while the food has never been exceptional, it was edible. Tonight, it was a different story. The sauce for the honey chicken had no... I'ma stop you there. We did refund your money back despite all the inconsistencies in your claims. We also went through your order history and found out this was not the first time. For every order, you always made up an excuse, or wait several days, then calling back saying the order was not satisfactory. Oh, so she's just stealing food. She's just doing a refund scam. She goes back saying that something was wrong with the food, gets her money back, and then essentially she got a meal for free. That's so scummy, and I really hope she gets caught, because most people don't. Just most people get banned from going to a specific Popeyes or a specific Chick-fil-A. They don't really see any jail time for stealing food, but I really wish that there's some sort of retribution for that, because it's awful. Hi, I'm a teen influencer with 47,000 TikTok followers, and I get 100,000 views per video. Most of my audience is 14 to 17 years old and would love your jewelry and t-shirts. I want to collab with you by advertising your products to help grow your business. If you send me 3 of your most expensive items in your store, I'll make a TikTok vid about them, and I hope to hear back from you. Yeah, hi there! The best way you can support our small business is by purchasing from it. I clicked on your TikTok and it seems like you get 200 views per video and your followers are 12. Unless your 1,000 TikTok followers with no forms of currency can help me pay off my student loans, please stop asking small businesses for free stuff. Thanks. I truly don't understand why people get so airheaded when they reach a specific follower account on an online website. I don't really understand it. It doesn't make sense to me. Because at the end of the day, without those follower accounts, you know, subscriber accounts, whatever it may be, you're still the same person. Without those numbers, you're still the same. I don't understand what makes you think that you can become such a big and influential person, you know, to use the term that they're using, right? And contact people for free stuff. That's nuts. 100 plus hours, probably over 50,000 blocks, just a foundation of a city. OP has no armor, 4 levels, empty hotbar, no stats, no before pick, and threw all of the cobble in the ocean, even though he's planning on building a city. Ah, why do you doubt the man? It's not like he would lie about something like this on r/gaming or just any other subreddit that's gaming related or Minecraft related. No way, there's nothing that he can gain from lying, right? Certainly not 2,800 downvotes. Everybody wants that. Yo, I wrote my ex a letter, and this woman decided to grade it and send it back. Uh-huh, crazy story, dude. Didn't know your name was Elizabeth, though. You see, this isn't a joke. This is straight up, look how quirky I am, and look at how weird my life is. Yeah, dude, you're not fooling anyone. Why are you just taking memes from the internet and repurposing them into your fake life? Don't do that stuff, because you're gonna get called out, and it's gonna be embarrassing. And now I get to laugh at you, and a bunch of other people get to laugh at you, too. We're all laughing together at your idiocy. How old were you when you found out that the creator of Subway Surfers made the game in memory of his son who died skating on a train track? Oh man, that's awful. There's no way a story like this can be untrue. Nobody would go out of their way to make something this macabre up for, you know, Twitter like. No, he didn't. The game came after the creators did a short film about this graffiti dude being chased around in the subway by the police. The film won a prize for Best Animation Movie at Hamburg Animation, so they pitched the game idea to the Danish Film Institute. I swear, I think people just love making up stories to, I guess, entertain themselves or just entertain others. I really don't understand why someone would go out of their way to make a backstory like this. It doesn't even sound like a rumor. It just sounds like something that you came up with. Which, you know, obviously you did, but the question still stands, why did you do it? While I'm happy to hear there might be a second stimulus check, I still never received the first one. Even though I submitted my taxes for both 2018 and 2019, I mean, I legit had to work 2 jobs just to pay rent and have enough food. Bro, you only work 10 hours a week! You wasted your money on power tools, beer, and video games! Didn't your mom claim you as a dependent? She was paying for your car, food, and medical. There was also a student relief fund for you, specifically for students to pay their rent. Like, seriously, shut up, basement boy. Ooh, my god, you didn't have to do it to him. You really cut him deep. I really hope this guy gets his life together, because he's still waiting on government checks. That's not gonna happen. I don't know if there's gonna be another stimulus check, but dude, get your life together. Why is your mom paying for your whole life? You sound like you're probably 20, dude. You gotta stop. Yo, I just got assaulted in Central Park. Don't go out tonight. Stay inside, stay safe. Hashtag blackout, hashtag New York. Dude, that's just weird. So, you steal a picture of a guy getting beat up simply for being Welsh, and you use it to talk about being beaten up in Central Park during, like, the 4-hour blackout in New York. Why? For clout? You got 16 likes and 6 comments, one of them debunking you and just exposing you for the liar that you are. I don't understand how this was worth it for you. Yo, Mike Scott, when asked to explain how his preparation changes as a starter, not much really. Probably just make sure my vape pen is fully charged. What? When did I say this? The really sad thing about this entire situation is that Mike Scott's, you know, tweet actually has less likes and retweets than the lie. Jesus, do people believe Jimmy more than Mike Scott? Why can I not post anything? Like, no pictures. KK, never mind. I drew this. Bruh? No, you didn't. You didn't draw it. Stop lying on Discord. I guess I don't understand why you would lie about something like this. Help me out here. Why not just post cool dog? Why the bullshit? Yeah, that's so strange, right? Like, these guys go out of their way to make some elaborate stories about how they came across the dog, or how an injury is the reason why they have the dog, just like this situation, right? Why? Why can't you just post cool dog that looks like Scooby-Doo? You would get the same karma. Hey, my best Spider-Man drawing ever. Come on, take a look at it. Yeah, I don't think so, because you didn't draw that. A guy named Lethal Chris put it on DeviantArt in 2018. It's the same exact picture, same markers on the side, stolen valor. Unless you go by Lethal Chris and drew this a couple years ago, but my spidey senses say otherwise. Ah, I see what you did there. You dropped a little... Got a little pun in there. I see what you did there. I see it. I see what you did. Yo, let me be your boo.
Let me be your boo.
Bruh, you broke. Why would you even want a girl who likes you for your money? That's really awful and sad. Stop being so cringe and go get yourself a Discord girlfriend like everybody else. A crazy realization from the SpongeBob official Twitter when you realize you've never seen his backyard. No, SpongeBob fact. In the classic episode Naughty Nautical Neighbors, SpongeBob's backyard can clearly be seen. You might want to delete this official SpongeBob account. Don't you love living in this timeline where literally the official SpongeBob Twitter account can have a false statement and an unofficial SpongeBob facts Twitter account can clown on them and debunk it? That's amazing. That's amazing. You understand how magical that is? That was a rare moment in time. This better be in history books. So, I've been working on this for a while. Did you really just try and take credit for this? Something you made in a Minecraft art converter? You can tell it's made in an art converter because when calculated, the image is 900 plus by 400 plus, which is around 360,000 blocks. Let's assume that you take a second to place 5 blocks down. When you do the math, that means you must have sat there for 20 hours straight and created this. Now that's assuming that you did this without error at your maximum possible speed, and even when you did it in the air. Minecraft pixel art is much harder to do in mid-air. I would know because I've worked on many creations before. This is because you have to do it bottom up instead of creating an outline and working on the edges to the center. Also, it's because you don't have a background to place the blocks on. If you take human error, vertically, and just the pure size of this image into consideration, it's almost impossible for you to have created this by yourself. You also have claimed somewhere in the comments section that you've used Minecraft pixel art converter and made it by using that picture and then placing the blocks yourself. That means you zoomed into the photo and placed each and every individual block perfectly without any overshooting on block placements or anything. That is where I can cast an almost certain doubt over your claims. I've worked on many pixel art pieces, and in my larger scale creations, even with a reference to how I'm supposed to create it, I've overshot the number of blocks I'm supposed to place, leaving me with a messed up final creation. On a piece this big, mistakes like that wouldn't be realized until the creation is finished, and would leave no room for improvement due to you needing to destroy most of the art to fix it. There is not a single mistake in this entire creation. No block misplaced at all, nothing placed wrong. On top of that, you even managed to have the letter spelled exactly right, with no letter having any mistakes in it. Don't lie and say you made this. There is no possible way you did. And if you did it how you claimed, then I can assure you you're lying for karma. I'd estimate an art piece this big would take over 100 hours to complete if you're copying it from a picture with human error involved. And built vertically, I feel like it would take even longer than that. What you're speaking is bullshit. Cut it out. Hold up, I got more to say. Edit. I would also like to add on that OP said that he searched up Minecraft pixel art converter when he had been asked how he created this. He said he used the results to build it block by block. This is even more bullshit, and here's why. The first result when you search up Minecraft pixel art converter is a website where you can input any image, and it'll convert it to pixel art from Minecraft. On this website, if you put the Emoji Movie USSR image, it will start off with a design that's 900 blocks by 600, which is the exact number of blocks used for this. As I found out after scanning this image and using individual blocks seen as reference, this means that we can confirm that OP had used this site to create this image. What OP didn't know about this site is that it doesn't allow you to see the pixel art creation before you put it into a world. You are given a string of code that has a creation pre-installed onto it. I don't understand very much about downloading pixel art, but I do know that there is no way that OP read the string of code generated, decoded it, used the specific blocks described in the string of code in certain locations, and then posted it. Especially since his story was that he used the generator, looked at the image generated, and copied it from it. No matter how he tried to defend it, there is no way that he could have done this. Holy fucking shit! What's up everybody, it's your boy Ailurus, aka Panda Daddy, and I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, let me know in the comments down below, and leave a like if you liked the video, and if you're new to my channel, go ahead and subscribe, fam. What you doing watching videos and not subscribing? And if you're old, make sure you hit that bell so you get these notifications every time. Seriously, go ahead and take a look at this picture, make sure it looks like the picture, make sure you have those notifications on so you can get, you know,
my uploads on time, because don't you want to see my uploads? Come on, watch them. You know you want to. If you don't, that means you're a sour apple.
And as always, we gotta thank the Patreon supporters. Thank you to Taki, Bunny Boo, Dustin, Canned Eggplant, Kyle, Host Mark, Keith Myers, Hannah, PixieArt5, Lil Ring Green, Catherine Taylor, Jason, Arolina, Clara, John Robinson, Ethan, Vermont, Noobsler, Trenton Golden, Trojan, Yeetmaster, Arjun, Noah, Brody, Muffy Lou Who, Cleric, Sir Teacup, and Immortal EXE, and Trey. Thank you so much for your support. It is greatly appreciated. And if you want to help support the channel, there's two links in the description, one to my merch store and one to my Patreon. Both funds go directly into the channel so we can maintain what's happening here. And as always, stay zesty!